this strange and unique NASCAR tale, I'd like to go back and revisit the 2016 Quaker State 400 at Kentucky Speedway, and more specifically, the inspiration for this video comes from an article by Mark Story in the Lexington Herald Leader. 61-year-old salesman Tom Schlottman was sat inside a Kentucky Speedway hospitality suite when out of nowhere he watched as black smoke rolled over the grandstands. He asked his son-in-law Jeremy Smith, "What burns black like that?" Smith replied, "Petroleum-based products like rubber and car parts." Suddenly, with great timing, the emergency sensor on Schlottman's car fob began to vibrate. He knew then exactly what was happening. He turned to his daughters and said, "I think that's my car on fire." For years, Schlottman had actually watched NASCAR on TV, and as a Father's Day gift in 2016, his family purchased him tickets to see his very first race in person. On top of this, when Schlottman told his brother, Michael Schlottman, the chief financial officer for the Kroger company, that he was going to this race, he said that he would actually make a few calls. And that's how Tom Schlottman came to find himself inside a suite that night for the Quaker State 400. When Schlottman and his family pulled into Speedway parking area, he parked behind a white pickup truck with a grill in the back. Schlottman recalled looking at the grill and thinking to himself, "They're going to plop that thing down right in front of my car, and that could be trouble." So after this, he asked a Kentucky Speedway parking attendant if he could pull up and park beside the white pickup truck instead. Perhaps the decision would be regretted later on, as before the race was a third over, the black smoke came billowing over the grandstands. As the emergency sensor on his key fob kept going off, he told his family he had to walk out there and check on the car. Long before he had reached the Maxima, Tom knew already what he would find. He asked someone what car was on fire, and he said, "It's a black Maxima." Schlottman replied and said, "It was gray when we drove it in here." Meanwhile, while Tom was trying to figure out how bad his car was, NASCAR and NBC was broadcasting the race and cut to the unfortunate scene happening in the parking lot, where you can see the white pickup truck with the grill in the back and Tom Schlottman's Maxima to the left and somebody's red Chevy Colorado to the right of the truck. This then set social media off, and most people were speculating that the grill in the back of the pickup truck had gotten too hot and ignited a fire. However, contrary to that belief, the grill was not the cause of the fire, as Kentucky Speedway General Manager Mark Simondinger explained that the fire had actually started in the cab of the white pickup truck after the occupant had actually fell asleep inside. Speedway first responders were able to pull the gentleman from the cab, and he did not suffer a serious injury. In the police report, the official cause of the fire is that the man fell asleep with his cell phone charging and it overheated the console and the fire started. Surprisingly, with an unrestrained fire that happened in an open parking lot, only 3 vehicles were damaged. And while the race was happening inside, a lot of fans found themselves gathering to the edges of the grandstand to see what was happening in the parking lot. After the firefighters finally got to the fire, the white truck took the worst of the damage, the red Colorado was singed on the left side, and Schlottman's 2014 Maxima, which he said only had 65,000 miles on the odometer, was totaled. So Schlottman suddenly had to address his new concern: how does he get home? He's in Sparta, Kentucky, and needs to get back to Cincinnati, Ohio. He's literally out in the middle of nowhere now. So he then turned to the help of the company in whose suite he was watching the race, Race Management Systems. RMS had a connection with the team of Cup Series driver AJ Allmendinger, JTG Daughtry Racing. They got in touch with the team of the 47 car, and they said a car would be ready to take them home whenever they were ready. Schlottman did choose to leave the facility many laps before Brad Keselowski would take the checkered flag, leaving behind a burnt car. However, despite leaving the race early for reasons of life perspective, he did not leave mad. In 2012, his wife of 34 years, Susan, sadly died from bladder cancer, according to the article, and Tom agreed that once you live through that, losing a car is no big deal. However, I am pleased to say that this story does have a happy ending. Kentucky Speedway paid the bill to have Tom's Maxima towed off, and car insurance paid for Tom's new ride, a nice new Toyota Avalon. A mighty fine choice, sir, if I may add. In 2017, Kentucky Speedway's Simondinger did call to invite Schlottman to sit in the general manager's box for the 2017 Quaker State 400, and Tom said he would have loved to have gone, but a family friend's wedding actually kept him away in 2017. Simondinger did say that he definitely still wants Schlottman to sit in the box with him one day. I do not know if he got the chance to do so for 2018, but I hope he also gets a chance to do so in 2019 as well. However, Tom Schlottman still has the memory of his very first NASCAR race at Kentucky Speedway, where his car was the true hot rod that night, and not that of race winner Brad Keselowski. Again, thank you to Mark Story for the article that inspired this video. A link to the article is down below. I highly recommend giving some love to him by reading his complete story. I do not know what became of the owners of the white and red pickup trucks that night, but if you are watching this video today, please leave a comment down below and let me know what happened after that night. So what did you all think of what happened that night? It was wild, wasn't it? There was definitely more to the story than I ever imagined before researching it. Go ahead and feel free to leave a comment down below. Please give the video a like, it really helps my channel out a lot. And if you're new here, or you just haven't done so already, please hit the subscribe button and be sure to turn on notifications so that you never miss a new video. Also, you can follow me on Twitter at DannyBTalks to stay in touch. This is Danny B, and thanks so much for watching my new video, and I hope you have a great day. Bye guys.